It's time for the match game, Hollywood Square. Power with from the Fall Guy, Markie. From Goodnight Beantown, Jim Staahl. Blake Clark. Nedra Volz. Fred Travalena. And the stars of the match game, Hollywood Square's Hour,
Not bad.
Thank you very much, and we greet you one and all. Greet my friends out there.
Hi, everybody.
Oh, isn't that splendor? We're here to do the match game Hollywood Square is Our, and we're going to, with your help, we're going to start that right now by giving a big round of applause to our stars. Let's all say, hello, stars.
Not bad.
Hello, stars.
Hello.
You're all ready to have a go at it, are you?
We certainly are, Gene.
Thank you, Ollie. You're in the leather, huh?
Yes.
I see.
No leather over here.
Keep your hands off the fat lady, okay?
Thank you so much.
I'm Ollie.
Mind your own business.
Here's the man of a thousand voices. Is there a new voice that we haven't heard?
A new voice that we, yes.
There is?
Yes, Robert Wagner.
Robert
Wagner from Heart to Heart, right? How would you like to see Robert Wagner running for president?
I'd like that.
Very difficult. All right.
Now, let me get this straight. First of all, they told me if I run for president, I can't mention my TV show. So all I'm going to say is, if I'm elected in the tradition of Reagan, Carter, and FDI, every week I'm going to have a radio show so I and the American people can have a little heart to heart.
I'm asking you, huh? Haven't heard that one. That's a tough one. Very good. Okay, let's keep it going now as we say hello to Tori Whipple and Cindy Smart. How about those? I say, those are two show business names, if I've ever heard one. Cindy Smart and Tori Whipple. Are you an act?
No.
Tori, let's find out who you are and where you're from.
Well, I'm originally from New York. My husband and I live now in Santa Monica. I'm a marathon runner, and in my spare time, I help him with his magazine.
Really? How many miles a week do you run, Tori?
I run about 85 to 90 miles a week.
Every week?
Yes.
Where do you run?
Everywhere.
Wow, that's marvelous. All right. Cindy, tell us about you, please.
Well, I'm married. I have two adorable daughters, Shanna and Cherise, and I'm a busy apartment manager.
Oh, you are?
Yes.
All right. Good luck to both of you. Shall we begin?
Yes, we shall.
All right. Each of you will have three opportunities to match as many of those things as you can over there. And the one who's done that most often at the end of the third round will be the winner and go on to challenge our returning champion on Hollywood Squares for a chance to win up to $30,000. Tori, you won the toss. You go first.
I'm going to take B, please.
All right. No one noticed I said you won the tross. You're not listening, are you? Yes. She says, Sandra, or Sandra, has given up on ever finding Mr. Right. She's so desperate, she'd even marry Mr. Blank. Good. Put it right in the slot, and away we go. Everybody ready down here? Yep. Except John. Okay. Tori. Sandra has given up on ever finding Mr. Right. She's so desperate, she'd even marry Mr. Blank.
Even marry Mr. Wrong.
Mr. Wrong?
Yes.
All right.
Mr.
Say Mr. Whipple because your name is Whipple.
But he
doesn't like you to squeeze his Charmin, so I figured you'd say Mr. Wrong or Mr. Semi-Okay.
Mr. Wrong or Semi-Okay. Very good. One for Tori. Hello, Margie.
Hello. It was between left and wrong, and wrong one.
Yeah. surprised me.
I thought for sure it'd be Mr. Coffee.
Mr. Coffee.
Or Mr. Dishes do this. But I said Mr. Wrong. Okay. And the guy in the sound was going, I hit the
right. She's up to three. Given up on ever fighting Mr. Wright, she's so desperate she'd even marry Mr.
Well, I don't think that Mrs. Whipple is going to squeeze me. At least not in the way I would like her to. Because I said Mr. Whipple.
Aha. Uh-huh. You know who Mr. Whipple is, don't you?
Vaguely, yes.
Well, he's in that commercial, you know?
I've heard it many times.
Oh, all right. Okay, Fred.
Well, thinking in the line of voices to do, I went right along with the A-team. I said, Mr. T.
Mr. T. Nedra.
Well, you see, I have a movie coming out, Gene, that I work with an orangutan, you see, so I'm sort of hung up on him, you know what I mean?
You're right.
So I said, Mr. Smith.
Mr. Smith. You're hung up on an ape, are you,
well,
Nedra?
Well, you know.
Right.
Change of blood.
Okay. Oh, you're too much. All right, Cindy, this one is for you. Robert Young said,
Gene,
it's easy
so
for
me. Gene, why so tender?
It's easy for me to do without caffeine. To really get me going in the morning, I drop a blank in my shorts.
Drops a blank.
It's easy for me to do without caffeine. To really get me going in the morning, I drop a blank in my shorts.
Inspiration is coming here.
Okay. I'm sorry.
Okay, Cindy.
Yes.
Robert Young said, it's easy for me to do without caffeine. To really get me going in the morning, I drop a blank in my shorts.
A lump of sugar.
No, you don't understand. See, what he does is he loosens his belt and he takes something and he drops it. What do you think a lump of sugar would do down there? Don't answer that question. She said a lump of sugar. It's unlikely that anybody here said a lump of sugar, but we must go through the formality. All right, Blake, you're up first.
Every morning that I get up, I put a lump of sugar in my shirt.
You do? Yes. Why do you do that?
Because, never mind. I can't say that on the air.
All right.
But I said that he would put a frog
a
in
frog
his
pants. A frog would get you going. You see, it would be slippery and jump around. Frog is good. Markie?
Sean.
Well, first I said a cup of hot coffee, and then I said an ice cube. I ended up with a firecracker. I'm sorry I didn't get to a cube.
I thought for a moment you might have been the one to match her. What do you say?
See, I knew we were getting close to the Christmas season, so I said a hot coal.
A hot coal.
That would get going.
That would get you going, all right. John, what would get Mr. Young going in the morning?
I really didn't think this was a very good answer, Gene, until I heard lump of sugar. A whole lot better about frog.
Oh, frog, I think, is quite good. Frog is a good answer, right?
Yes, well, when we did the Smurfs, I did the voice of Dreamy Smurf, and it wasn't the right answer, but we...
Dreamy Smurf wanted to get Gargamel going, so he put a firecracker in his shorts.
Uh-huh. Terrific, with an echo and everything.
I got my answer.
All right, Nedra.
Well, this might match, you see, because this cube of sugar might have a bomb in it, maybe TNT or something.
Well, you really try, don't you, Nedra?
Yeah, well, you know.
Cindy, you have none. Tori, you have three. And that's the way it is at this round one juncture. Round two coming up right after this. Here we go now. Round two coming up. Tori, you're ahead. You have to go first.
I'd like B again, please, Gene.
All right. Yeah, it'd be last time. Let's see what it holds for you this time. Did you hear about Dumb Dora?
No.
No.
She's... How here was she? Dumb Dora, we want to talk about her. She's been standing in her kitchen waiting for an earthquake just so she can make blank. Standing in her kitchen waiting for an earthquake.
I know.
You don't write, you don't write, you don't.
Yeah, let's see how well they do, Margie. Yeah.
All right. Here we go. Dumb Dora's been standing in her kitchen waiting for an earthquake just so she can make...
A milkshake?
Milkshake is a good answer. See, what would happen, the earthquake would come, and she'd be standing there with this jug in her hand, and all the ingredients would be in it. Let's go, John.
I really can't cook, but even so, I don't think this is ridiculous.
No,
scrambled
right.
eggs?
Scrambled eggs would be good. Another good choice.
Scrambled. My people.
Fred?
This is Julia Child.
What are you cooking?
Is my you answer's making me do that.
You have something in the oven, Julia.
No, I hope not. My God, I'm too old for that. Bon appetit. I said an upside-down cake.
Of course. That's good for an earthquake. Nedra?
I said scrambled eggs.
So we had two orders of scrambled eggs and one upside-down cake. All right, Cindy, a chance for you to catch up a little bit here with your round two question. Harry said, let me tell you how my brother-in-law went broke. He tried to make a living selling bottomless blanks. Tried to make a living selling bottomless blanks. Everyone plays. All right. Here we go, Cindy. Harry said, let me tell you how my brother-in-law went broke. He tried to make a living selling bottomless blanks.
Trousers.
Bottomless trousers. Okay. Bottomless trousers. You'd go broke doing that.
Trousers don't have bottoms anyway. How could you get your feet through them if they had bottoms in them?
Well, no, she was thinking of this bottom here. You see, yeah. Nobody buys.
She was thinking of your bottom?
No.
Were you thinking of his bottom?
No, any bottom.
She said no. I was thinking more of, you know, like the opposite of topless. Which was
the
bottomless.
The opposite of topless?
Topless. I said a bottomless bra.
Aha.
Boo that. That's terrible.
Get it out of your system.
You have a winner, too?
The answer was so clear to me. It was buckets, of course.
Bottomless buckets. You'd go broke trying to sell
those. Couldn't think of a thing.
Right. You applaud, Bucket.
Right.
See, I deserve to be booed, too. I kept getting this vibration, pants, so I wrote it down and changed it to bottomless swimming pools.
Aha. Uh-huh.
See, you would go broke. You would lose more money with a swimming pool with no bottom.
That's right, because it wouldn't hold water. That answer doesn't hold water. Okay. All right.
That's funny.
John?
Yes, sir.
Have you got something for Cindy over there? Tried to make a living selling bottomless blanks?
I don't think, you know, bottomless trousers would be that great because I'm wearing bottomless trousers.
Really?
Sure.
Don't stand up.
So instead, I said, and of course you won't boo me because you've done it already, swimming pools.
Okay.
I knew it.
All right.
Since I didn't come up with the definitive answer, I'll have to go with someone really lovable so they won't boo me. So I'll say Stan Laurel giving this answer.
Well, certainly you'd go broke if you had something like that, Ollie, because certainly if you tried to make money with it, it wouldn't work because I tried to make money and I said, oh, no, I said bottles.
Bottomless bottles. You'd go broke trying to sell low. All right.
Well, that's the answer, good routine.
That's another fine answer.
Nedra?
Fix your top.
All I could think of was bottomless pits, and it was.
Bottomless pits. I guess that was kind of a tough one. All right. So there we are at the end of round two, and the score remains the same. 3-0 in Tori's favor. Round three coming up. Hurry back. See who wins. We go with round three. Now, this is the final round. And we'll see which of these ladies will be the winner. Tori, you're still ahead. You go first.
Well, I'll take B again.
All right, B.
That's right.
Okay. Did you have B both times before that?
Yes, I did.
C-3PO said. You know who C-3PO is?
No, I really don't.
I bet Fred doesn't.
I don't. C-3PO.
Would you care to tell me about it?
It's a character in Star Wars. C-3.
Oh, I'm C-3. Scared of those kind of shows.
You know, he talked like this. He walked into my
dog. Oh, is that who's that character? Oh,
that's C-3PO.
Well, yes. I live with one of those kind of shows.
Is it? I'll never go back to that rotten airport. When I walked through the metal detector, they made me screw my blank off.
Oh, wow.
You all right? You all right? You all right?
See, Gene, a bottomless pool, see?
Yeah, it wouldn't hold water.
See, it wouldn't hold water. And,
right.
You would lose. You know how much money alone?
Your second choice, please.
Right. Hey, it's 20,000 gallons for a one fill up.
That's right. See, that's what's the logic that I did.
All right. Tori, C-3PO said I'll never go back to that rotten airport. When I walked through the metal detector, they made me screw my blank off.
Head.
Okay. Okay, John, she says head.
Yes, it's not clever, but it works.
That's it. Four for Tori. All right.
Well, R2 would have said, I hate going through those airports. When I go through, they make me screw my thing off. And I don't know, R2, what did they make you screw off? And he said,
which is that answer. But my real answer was, buns off.
Screw my buns off. All right.
I know buns off, sure.
Buns off.
Russian, isn't it?
Russian.
Nedra?
Head.
Okay, Tori has five. That means you need five to tie, six to win. The game is not decided yet.
Okay.
Here we go. Harry said, I tried running my car on beer. Oh, I got great mileage. But every time I came to a stop, it blanked.
Yeah, with a bra.
Right.
Filtering it with a bra.
With a bucket.
All right, Cindy. Last chance.
Yes.
Harry said I tried running my car on beer. I got great mileage, but every time I came to a stop, it blanked.
Burped.
Burped. Okay. Cindy, you need five burps to tie. Six burps to win.
That's one. It ain't no downstream beer. It ain't no city beer. It's my car beer, and it burps.
A car burps. There we go. 5-1 the score.
Mine burped as well.
Burped or hiccup?
It also hiccuped, just in case.
All right.
Okay.
Burp. That's three.
That's three.
On a roll. You're gaining, Cindy. Score is now 5-3. Last round.
She's doing okay. Here comes another one.
All right. 5-4.
I have to answer this as Dudley Moore as Arthur.
Yeah, I tried that myself at my Rolls Royce. And I came to a stop sign at back.
All right. Nedra, it's up to you.
Yes!
Bert, that wins the game. Come on down, Cindy. Congratulations. I'll get back to you in a minute. Tori, it was a pleasure to meet you.
Thank you.
We're going to send you 87,000 pairs of jogging shoes. No, we'll send some nice gifts your way. Many thanks for being on the Match Game. Tori Whipple. Now, time to switch to Hollywood Squares. What we're going to do, Cindy, look at them bring the set in. Isn't that dramatic? Don't get your finger caught in there, you guys. Okay, we're going to bring three more stars out here. I'm going to change places with John Bauman for Hollywood Squares, and we're going to have a lot more excitement here. Don't go away. We'll be right back.
A member of our studio audience will receive a Sylvania video disc player. With laser technology, you may enjoy brilliant color pictures and special effects furnished by Sylvania. It's time for more of The Match Game. Hollywood Squares, our with From Days of Our Lives, Sean Stevens. From Dallas, Audrey Landers. And Arsenio Hall. And taking over the star of the Hollywood Squares, John Bauman. And now, John Bauman and the Hollywood Squares.
Thank you, Gene Wood. Welcome.
welcome everybody to the second half of the Match Game Hollywood Squares Hour. And I have with me Cindy Smart, who was so smart that she burped her way through the Match Game competition. And we also have three brand new celebrities, Arsenio, Shawn, and Audrey. Arsenio, speaking of burping, I understand that you had a very nice meal there at the NBC concert.
That's the best thing about the show, because the people don't know, like, right before the show, they feed us this really nice catered dinner and everything. And that's good, because, like, a lot of the game shows, I did a game show on one of the other networks, okay? And it, really, they gave us, like, bologna sandwiches, you know, and, like, some stolen peanuts that had United scratched out on them, you know? So I thank all you guys, Mr.
You know what else is neat is they send a limousine to pick you up.
Yeah.
And that's the first time that you get to ride in a limousine if somebody didn't have to die so you go in it. Right?
Hey, no, wait a minute. That was nice, yeah.
Get the dinner. Wait a minute. I didn't get no limo.
Okay, calm down, guys. They scratched United off the side of limos. Let's go, Cindy, play Hollywood Squares while there's still time. Felicia, you're probably wondering if we'd ever get here. Your name is Felicia Eccles, is that correct?
Correct.
And we did have a retired champion who was on our show for 5 days in a row, so that is the limit. She is off today. Felicia won the drawing of lots backstage to determine who was going to sit in the returning champion's seat. Why don't you tell us a little bit about yourself?
I'm a legal secretary for a corporate law firm. I have 3 children, and I'm very busy.
Well, we're going to keep you busy today playing Hollywood Squares. We're going to play it until you hear the time's up bell. Whoever is ahead at that time will be our winner and goes on to play Supermatch for up to $30,000. Now, our first game is worth $100 plus $25 for every square either of you might capture. Our champion always gets to start. Felicia, you won that seat. Pick a square. Let's go.
I'll go with Gene.
Gene Rayburn.
Yes, the starter.
What does Elizabeth Taylor have more of, Gene? Oscars or children?
Well, she's had children by several different husbands, and, you know, she had some with Mr., what was his name, Wilding?
Michael.
Michael Wilding, yes.
I don't know why I'm helping him with that.
Then she had...
Fisher?
I don't know if you're counting, are you counting ones that she inherited from marriages, or just ones that she, natural children that she's had?
I believe it's just natural children that she's had.
All right, then it would definitely be Oscars.
Okay. Yeah, Gene says that Elizabeth Taylor has had more Oscars than she has had children. Agree or disagree, Felicia?
I will agree.
She has had more children than Oscars. According to this, we have 4 children versus 2 Oscars. Your opponent gets the first square and $25. Okay, Cindy Smart, take a look at the board. Pick a star for me.
Nedra.
Nedra Volz. According to the Cosmo Report, Nedra, what kind of lighting do most women prefer for making love? Daylight, dim light, or darkness?
Well, I don't know about other women, but I look much better in the dark. Yeah. Yeah, when I was singing for a living, that was a living. Well, I used the spot man. You say, what kind of spot do you? And I say, well, black is my best spot. Yeah. But I wind up in magenta because that gives it. That's okay.
That's Has she little, answered this yet?
There's a little trivia there. You just a little trivia.
Mm-hmm.
I think. What was that middle one?
It's most women. The middle one was dim light.
I like dim light. I want to see a little bit about what's going on. You know.
Dim the light.
Okay, Cindy. Nedra says that most women prefer dim light for making love. Agree or disagree?
I agree.
It is dim light. You're right. You get the square and $25. Oh, she's off to a real good start, Felicia. Pick a star for me.
Fred to block.
Uh-huh. You get this one, you do block. However, if you miss this one, Cindy will zip through the first game. Fred.
Yes.
Mr. T recently told People magazine that this is his favorite TV show. Is it 60 Minutes, Monday Night Football, or reruns of the Beverly Hillbillies?
Well, of course, I'm a little bit light today because it is light here, you understand? Foom.
I would say that it would be the Beverly Hillbillies. You understand, sucker?
I think I got it. Okay, Felicia, Fred says that Mr. T's favorite show is the reruns of the Beverly Hillbillies. To block, do you agree or disagree?
I disagree.
It is, in fact, reruns of the Beverly Hillbillies. No, you should have agreed with Fred, and your opponent gets that square and wins the first game. Good going. That was worth $100, gives you $175 so far. Nothing for you so far, Felicia, but we'll be right back to play a $200 game after this. You'll be back, too.
Stay tuned for more of the Match Game, Hollywood Squares Hour. Now, back to John Bauman and the Hollywood Squares.
For Smart Cindy Smart, and nothing so far for Felicia Eccles, but the next game is worth $200 and $25 for every square you capture. And since you lost the last game, Felicia, you do have an advantage in this one. You get the privilege of starting. Pick a star.
I'll take Markie.
Markie Post. You're an average sow.
Really?
That's it. I'm leaving.
Stop her, guys. Thanks.
Jesus.
Hey, you're no help. There's more to this than meets the eye. Imagine you're an average sow. Whoever is mooing a sow is a female pig.
That was Fred's impression.
Smart panel, huh? Okay.
I'm surprised he didn't.
We're really getting somewhere with this one. You're an average sow, Markie.
Yes.
According to the Old Farmer's Almanac, when will you be ready for your first mating? When you're a year old or as soon as you reach 250 pounds?
What?
Oh. I was going to say before I even heard the other two answers, because I thought it wasn't going to be a multiple choice, and I was going to say a year old. So for some reason, I think that's true. I think it's when a sow becomes a year old. This is important stuff, John.
Okay. You're also going to leave before you heard the other two answers. Okay. She says that a sow will be ready for his first mating when it's 1 year old. Agree or disagree, Felicia?
I'll agree.
It's as soon as the sow reaches 250 pounds. No, you should have disagreed, and Cindy gets the first square in this game. Okay, Cindy, pick a star for me.
Audrey.
Audrey Landers.
Okay.
Ow! Ow! Ow!
Have you hurt yourself, Arsenio? You've just broken your engagement, Audrey.
To a pig.
Oh, no!
According to Dear Abby, must you return the ring, or like any other gift, are you entitled to keep it?
I think you must return the ring.
Cindy, Audrey says that you must return the ring for a broken engagement. Agree or disagree?
I disagree.
You must return the ring, according to Dear Abby. No, you should have agreed with Audrey, and your opponent gets that square. It's even up, square to circle. Felicia, pick a square for me.
Nedra?
Nedra Volz.
Ow.
The skin from sharks was once commonly used to make something. Was it men's suit fabric or sandpaper?
Oh, sandpaper. Oh, I think it was used for man.
It's gaining on you.
Is that whale getting to me?
Did you?
I think it's to make men's clothing. I really do.
Felicia says that the skin from sharks was used to make men's clothing. Agree or disagree, Felicia?
I agree.
It was used to make sandpaper. No, you should have disagreed, and your opponent gets that square. Yes, shark skin's apparently a myth. The shark skin's huge. Fred?
You mentioned, you know, they have another sequel. They're going to have another Jaws film, speaking of sharks, and Pavarotti is going to sing the love theme from Jaws 4.
How does that go?
You wouldn't want it to show us how
Everybody
it goes, would you, Fred?
How does that go, Fred?
Suddenly! Because Pavarotti's going to be guesting soon on the Smurfs, apparently. Okay, Cindy, look at the board and pick a star for me.
Arsenio to win.
Uh-huh.
Thank you, because a lot of my relatives are terminally ill and they might not see tomorrow's show.
Arsenio, according to advertising expert David Ogilvy, if you want to attract a man's attention, should your ad feature a beautiful woman or another man?
According to who now?
Advertising expert David Ogilvy.
You know Dave.
Oh, Dave.
Dave.
That clears it up.
No, really, because if it was Sid, it'd be a different answer. No, I think it would have to be the female gender.
Cindy, Arsenio says that to attract a man's attention, your ad should feature a beautiful woman. For the game, do you agree or disagree?
I agree.
Your ad should feature another man. No, you should have disagreed, and your opponent blocks you. We will be back another to complete man. This $200 game after this.
Your hand.
Welcome back, everybody. It's 225 for Cindy, and so far 50 for Felicia. But Felicia, something extraordinary just happened to you. You are staying alive. Your opponent missed the last question, and now it's your turn.
I'll go with Shawn to block.
Okay.
John, wait, John. First of all, when I want to wake up in the morning, I drop one of these down my pants, and that would wake someone up real quick. Okay? Go back to bed. Shut up.
Okay, let's see if it helps you on this question. Shawn, according to the Merit Report, on the weekends, do more people go to football games, churches, or bars?
Which report was that?
The Merit Report.
Oh, the Merit Report.
That's the guy that worked on Ogilvy, isn't it?
I think in the United States, more people would go to church.
Okay. Now, Felicia, he says that more people would go to churches than the other two choices, according to this report, on Sundays. Now, this is, by the way, to win. I think you miscalled that yourself before. So the pressure is really on. Do you agree or disagree that more people go to church?
I will agree.
Yes, more people do go to church. And X gets that square, and you win the game. So you're better off than you thought. 275 to 225. That was our $200 game. This is our $300 game. Let us clear the board and begin. Felicia won that last one. That means Cindy gets to start this one. Pick a star.
Tough game. Gene
Rayburn.
I'm ready.
Still $25 for every square, and every $25 counts. Who printed more money in 1982, Gene? Parker Brothers for their game Monopoly or the United States Treasury?
Well, the way those dingbats are going in Washington, I would have to say the U.S. Treasury printed more money, much to my disgust and dismay.
Yeah.
Okay, Gene says the U.S. Treasury printed more money than Monopoly game. Agree or disagree, Cindy?
I'll agree.
The U.S. Treasury, it was. Yes, you were right to agree, and you get the square. $40 billion for the U.S. Treasury, $30 billion for Monopoly. All right, Felicia, your move.
Audrey
Landers.
I'm ready.
According to the director of sleep disorders at St. Luke's Medical Center, which sex tends to have dreams that are concerned with the size of things? Men or women?
I would say women.
Felicia, she says women are more prone to have dreams which are concerned with the size of things. Agree or disagree?
I'll disagree.
Men it is. You're right to disagree, and you get the square. She was smart on that one, Cindy Smart, but now it's your turn to be smart. Pick a star for me.
I'd have to try Nedra again.
Nedra Volz.
Ow! Ow! Ow!
Are you through with your public now, Nedra?
No, I'm never through with my public.
Well, imagine you're at a large dinner party.
Oh, large.
Should you wait for the host to begin eating before you start, or is it okay to eat as soon as your food is served?
Well, I'm so impolite, and I get so hungry. But I really think you should wait for the hostess to start eating.
Cindy,
I wish I could.
Cindy Nedra says you should wait for the host to begin eating before you start. Agree or disagree?
I agree.
You should eat as soon as your food is served. No, it's perfectly okay, and your opponent gets that square. All right, Felicia, there's a break for you. Pick a square for me.
This time, Jim to win.
Right. Jim.
Yes?
Your zipper is stuck.
Oh.
Wait, thank you.
No, I'm glad. You see my frog, Jim? I'll use the frog later.
Imagine your zipper is stuck.
All right.
Weight Watchers magazine recommends rubbing something on it to unstick it. Is it toothpaste or a candle?
Now, this has happened to me. I used a candle and because that helped lubricate the metal parts, which we know zippers are made of.
But see, Jim used a candle when it was lit. And it frightened me.
In a church.
I was there.
It's perfect sense because a candle worked. It worked. A candle.
Felicia, Jim says that if your zipper is stuck, you should use a candle to unstick it. Agree or disagree for a game win?
I will agree.
You should use a candle to unstick it. Maybe it really did happen. You win the game. And that bell means that time is up with $650. Felicia Eccles, you are a new champion. Congratulations. Well done. This is your first time. Go over there, join Gene Rayburn, get set for your shot at the big money. Here she goes. Cindy, you made it through the match game. This was a really tight contest. She kind of broke it open at the end. You're an excellent player. You're leaving here with $250 and our thanks. Yeah. And now, Gene Rayburn.
What? Oh, hold me.
You're on.
Oh, listen. We congratulate our winner here, and she's going to be back with all of our 9 celebrities and a goal for the big money right after these messages.
Now, here to play the super match is Gene Rayburn.
Thank you. Here we are. Felicia is ready to have a go at the big money now. For the big money super match, you can win up to $30,000, Felicia. Are you ready for that?
Yes.
Yes. Which one of us has the better looking legs? Just, I'll conduct my own poll here.
I don't know.
Thank you very much. All right. Let's get on with it now. We polled a recent studio audience and said, please write down your best answer to this. Blank cats. The top answer is worth $1,000. Second most popular, $500. And the third, $250. Three of our 6 stars are allowed to assist. Which 3 would you like? One at a time, please.
Shawn first.
One of my favorite groups. The Stray Cats.
The Stray Cats, all right.
Jim.
See, that's too hip. See, the broad-based American public would say copycats.
All right.
He's a copycat.
And Arsenio.
They took my answer.
Audrey will give you one.
Okay.
No, she
bad.
Called an Arsenio.
I got one. Okay, wait.
I got one.
I'll go with that.
He said
Ali Cats, but he means Alley Cats is what
he means. Alley Cats.
He said right. Alley Cats.
So you have Alley Cats, Copycats, and Stray Cats. Those are the 3. Now you have to make a decision here. You may choose one of their answers or think up one of your own.
I'll go with Alley Cats.
Alley Cats is what she wants. Let's find out if it's up there, and if so, where. Let's go down to the bottom and reveal the $250 response. Black Cats.
Oh,
a logical
Shawn,
response.
Shawn had that here.
Shawn had that one. Okay. Let's take a look at the next one, please. Alley Cats. There it is. That surprised me. What do you think is going to be on top?
Stray Cats, big group.
Strays. Strays. Hold everything. We'll find out right now.
She has 3 children. She should know that.
Stray is right. Audience is right. Stray Cats is up there.
There were Stray Cats long before there was a group.
What's that?
There were Stray Cats long before there was a group, the Stray Cats.
That's right.
She has 3 children. Sean.
Right. Okay, you've got the $500. Now you're going to play the head-to-head match with any star you pick. Now remember, each star has a number in front there, a 10, a 20, or a 30. If you choose one with a 10, we multiply your $500 by 10. If you choose one with a 20, we multiply by that number. And there's one up there with a 30. And if you choose that one, we'll multiply by 30. That means you'll be playing for $15,000. Time now to make your pick, Felicia.
Blake.
Yes.
All right, Blake.
All right.
Grab that tab and pull it up. 20. Very good.
That's good.
So it's a 20. That means you're playing the head-to-head. for $10,000. A pretty good sum.
Okay.
Here it is. You're going to write your response, and hers will be verbal when you're finished. Calvin Blank. C-A-L-V-I-N blank. No help from the audience, please. And then, of course, at this part of the game, it has to be an exact match. All right. Ding, ding. Thank you very much. All right, he's finished. Oh, good morning. He's finished for $20,000. Try to match him with this. Calvin.
Klein.
Calvin Klein. All right. Us old folks were thinking of Calvin Coolidge
here.
Yeah,
I was thinking of Calvin.
You were thinking of Calvin Coolidge?
Yeah, but I said Calvin Klein. Ha 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 ha!
Had a goal! Wonderful! Felicia, you have $11,150. All right, give him a high five. Give him a high five, Blake. Bang! They missed. All right, $11,150. Congratulations to you. We'll be back right after these messages. Find out which celebrity had the big 3-0. John, let's all pull the tabs together. Ready, set, go.
Whoa!
John, you had it. Hey, wonderful. Listen, we'll be back here tomorrow with our 9 celebrities here. This champion will return. Gene Reverner saying goodbye with the Match Game Hollywood Squares Hour.
John Bauman, too. So long.
Bye.
A member of our studio audience will receive a Roper Easy Touch Microwave Oven featuring computerized cooking with 3 memory levels. Let you automatically program exactly the right temperature, power, and cooking time for any foods furnished by Roper. This is Gene Woods speaking for the Match Game Hollywood Squares Hour. A Mark Goodson Television Production.